Live in HD from the station that brings you more West Texas news. News West 9 at 10 starts now.
Exclusive report. News West 9 spoke with one of the sisters of the jailed woman who claims to know what happened to missing Colorado City teen Hailey Dunn.
This week, we reported law enforcement agencies are shifting their investigation of Dunn's disappearance to Odessa. Sonja Callahan wrote a letter from jail claiming she saw a young girl who matched Hailey's description. In the letter, she claims this girl was held against her will and drugged in an Odessa home. She wrote that the girl eventually died of an overdose and was dumped behind the Ector County Coliseum.
Now, investigators searched that area, but they did not find anything. So far, nothing from the letter has turned out to be credible, but this is an ongoing investigation.
Tonight, you'll hear from Callahan's sister, who was one that notified Abilene officers about that suspicious letter. Jen Kastner joins us with the story. Jen.
Mike, Crystal, Sonja Callahan's older sister tells us that Callahan told her that this alleged incident inside of an Odessa home was all from a dope deal that went horribly wrong, and Hailey was supposedly used as collateral for a drug debt that she says her family owed money on. This is Mialinda Martin of Abilene. She's the older sister of Sonja Callahan, currently locked up by the feds in Odessa for narcotics, and the supposed whistleblower on the alleged truth behind Hailey's disappearance. Roughly 4 months ago, Callahan sent a letter to one of her sisters, Hope.
My sister Hope called me and she's like, you really need to look at this because she's saying that it's Hailey Dunn because she had told her over the phone that it was Hailey Dunn.
To be clear, we're told that the letter never actually mentions the girl's name. Only was that done in phone calls. Callahan writes that the girl was forcibly held in an Odessa home, and she claims she was there to witness all of the horror that she says that teen endured.
She said today, whenever I talked to her, she said that it was Hailey Dunn. And she went into detail a few days ago on how what Hailey was wearing, how she was rocking back and forth, how they were laughing in her face.
The letter also claims that the girl was drugged. Mialinda Martin says Callahan told her why.
And the reason she said that they overdosed her, they gave her drugs, is because she was so out of it. She was so freaked out.
Eventually, according to the letter, the girl died. Her body dumped behind the Ector County Coliseum. Detectives searched there but found nothing. But Mialinda says her sister has never been a very reliable source and has an extensive history of landing behind bars.
Tell me about whether or not you really believe this.
I don't know if I believe it. I don't know if I should or not, you know? Honestly, I don't know.
An investigation into this entire incident is still underway. Now, Mialinda also told us that her sister was a narcotics informant for nearly 10 years for the Sheriff's Department in Abilene. Officers there, however, tell us they cannot divulge into any information as to who they use as informants. Reporting in the control room, Jen Kastner, News West 9.